and I can't understand why my switchboard is lighting up with people who want to blame the owners. Blame the granny, that's right. Not the dogs that savaged the little boy to death. Go ahead, Terry, in Sittingbourne in Kent.
Yeah, hello, Jules.
Hi, mate.
Right, I'm a first-time caller to you.
Welcome.
Regarding the dogs, I don't think you should be allowed to have a dog when you've got young children in the house. Common sense tells you that. And also, regarding the unions and the, you know, the oil refinery, they sold out again. They should have held out for, you know, 100 jobs between the English workers, British workers. It's not right. You shouldn't have them. That, we've got enough people out of work. When there's a recession, you shouldn't be allowed to employ foreign workers.
Yeah, but that's just crazy, Terry, because we've got 1.5 million British workers working in elsewhere in the European Union, and they would immediately be sent home by the countries in the European Union, and that would make the unemployment, that would double the unemployment.
Well, that's my opinion. I just think it's...
But answer that point. Answer that point, Terry.
No, I won't. I've got my opinions. My opinion is that in a recession, there shouldn't be people brought in to do work that English workers can do.
And what about the 1.5 million British workers? You keep saying English. British workers that would then
not
be expelled...
British workers, then. Whatever you like
then,
to call them.
Then they would be expelled from the European countries that they're working in, and they'd be back here on the dole.
If they've already got a job there and they've been working there some time... Then they're entitled to stay.
No, they're not entitled to stay there. No, no.
But to bring people in on a boat and give them work.
Terry, please don't confuse this issue. If you in Britain, if we in Britain said that we were not allowing foreign workers to be taken on, then the other countries in the European Union would immediately retaliate by sending the 1.5 million British workers working in their countries home. And that would double our unemployment. What you're saying is just illiterate nonsense.
No, it's not. It's
well,
right,
answer the point then if it's
no,
not.
Right, the point is this. Is if you've got unemployment in France, you don't bring in, English workers to do the jobs when you've got thousands and hundreds of thousands.
But there already are. There already are.
Yeah, well, what's there
now? A million and a half
you can't
working
do
overseas.
Nothing about what's there now. But as from now the recession's here, they should bring in a law where you don't bring in foreign workers.
But then the other country...
Every country...
Terry, I've had enough of that.